it all together.
There you go.
She's definitely a strong woman, and I think that's an incredible thing to be able to show her student athletes growing up that this is what we need to do, and this is the voice we need to have, and not be afraid to have that voice, because I think that's a hard thing to really be able to embody, especially when we're young.
Besides the knowledge of the game of ice hockey, both as a player and as an assistant coach, she brought high energy. She brought a commitment to excellence on the part of the athletes, and she brought just a marvelous philosophy of sport and education. She cared about the students as athletes, but it was really important that they fulfill their role as students first. So many times, particularly on the college level, that the athletes are regarded as athletes, as they belong to the institution. And their success as students, which is why they're in the institution, is totally disregarded. Digit was quite vehemently opposed to this as an approach. She drives herself, she drives the students, and I think that that's why she has been so successful at Brown.
What I found out is I learned a ton from Dij. She was somebody who taught me to stand up for what I believe in, be confident, and make sure that I was a good teammate day in and day out. And I think at the end of my 4 years at Brown, I was a proud, confident person and ready to take on any challenge. Biggest thing I learned from Digit was perseverance. She constantly talked about, I remember she would always yell at me, it's called adversity, Gardner. It'll make you stronger. You gotta push through it. And the lessons about, she taught me that I could do way more than I thought I could do, that my limit was much higher than I thought it was, and she pushed us to reach that. She got us to get the very best out of us, and I took that with me through the next 10 years of my life. Lessons about, you know, competition, striving to be better, it translates off the ice, it translates into life, it translated into motherhood, and the lessons I like to teach my daughters come from Digit.
Thank you, Digit, for all that you've done, because I think we wouldn't be here. I certainly wouldn't be in this position without what you've sort of done for us and paved the way for women's hockey.
There's no question Digit is a pioneer for women's hockey and for women's sport. And I guess another adjective I would use is maverick or noun. She was not afraid. If someone said no, she said, why not? And she has a lot of strength.
I would like to thank you for your many years of dedication to and passion for the sport of women's ice hockey. You have certainly left your mark. And I think back to the early days when you and I were coaching, when we were the only two female head hockey coaches, and we had our coaches association meetings in a small room at Harvard. And then you and I became president and secretary treasurer of that group. I don't think you wrote up many minutes of the meetings, but it was still a lot of fun. Then we created the ECAC League, and I have something here that you might remember. This nice plaque that you gave me for the formation of the ECAC Women's Hockey League. That's an inside joke. But really, you have had a lot to do with the growth of our sport. It's now an Olympic sport, and we have a national championship, so thank you for your hard work.
There is no doubt in my mind that women's ice hockey would not be where it is today at a very good level of competitive competitiveness if it were not for the energy and the force of Digit Murphy. She is a pioneer. She is highly respected.
And the legacy that you are leaving is a great one. You've taught life lessons to your players. You've shown courage in standing up for what you think is right. So your courage, your compassion, and your commitment to the sport have certainly been awesome. So thank you for everything. And there's one last thing. You're still older than I am. Thank you very much.